Joining us, I'm Kristen Gatesman, and you're probably more than just familiar with FIRST Robotics. Our elementary, middle, and high schools have participated in this worldwide competition for years, and Myrtle Beach hosts a regional FIRST Robotics competition this month. And now, one of our middle schools has discovered and taken on a new FIRST competition called the FIRST Technology Challenge. We'll visit these students who are the very first to compete in this FIRST activity. Plus, we'll give you the dates and times of the FIRST regional competition held here and information on our 8th annual technology fair happening in March. All of that right now as we take you inside Horry County Schools. These are familiar images, students proudly demonstrating and competing with robots that they've imagined, built, and programmed for FIRST robotics competitions.
I'm standing behind our robot, Mr. Roboto. He can collect and shoot wiffle balls into like a sort of basketball hoop.
But usually we only see either Lego League robots or we see these robots made by our high school students.
Yeah, you see those high school robots and that's a big leap.
That's when these Ocean Bay Middle School Lego League robotics team members saw a FIRST Technology Challenge robot at their last competition.
It's a lot more challenging and we've been doing Lego League for a while, so we wanted to do something a little bit different.
FIRST Lego League is more of a multiple choice test, whereas in there are things that are preset. And this FIRST Tech Challenge is more of an essay test because you're writing your own code, you're doing more of your own things, and it's not preset. In this programming, you sort of have to write it out yourself, so it's a lot harder to do. You have to memorize more things, but it gives you an opportunity to do more. You can have methods, variables, classes, things like that, which aren't even in the EV3 programming.
This is the very first Horry County Schools robotics team to participate in the FIRST Technology Challenge competition. And although this is a rookie team, they feel as if they've won.
We set up goals at the beginning of the season that we wanted to get competition with a working robot and we wanted to score. And we met all of those. Right, we did great.
Besides the robot and competition, students in FIRST Technology Challenge have to show judges the process they went through to build and program their robot.
In the engineering process, you design solutions, and an engineering journal is sort of cataloging what you do so that you can go back and figure out what the measurements were made before. So think maybe you programmed something, and you changed a value. But maybe that value wasn't really what you should have changed. The engineering journal is cataloging it so that you can go back and put the original value back in. Yeah, that's basically what we're doing. We're the scientific method, which is the engineering process.
In fact, these students are so excited about FIRST Technology Challenge that they spread the word and demonstrated their robot at other FIRST competitions.
They wanted to get out there and say, look, there's this other thing going on. We can do more. Yeah, they were very excited. And it's not just about being the first one in Horry County, but being able to say, look, we can go to other schools and tell them about it and get them excited.
My favorite part was going to the competition, competing, meeting all the other teams, driving the robot on the field, seeing the innovative solutions.
They were even recognized for their hard work and enthusiasm.
Okay, we were the only team that had seventh graders on it, because it's the youngest age that you can be. And we had the least amount of members out of the entire thing.
And the least amount of experience.
Yeah, so we actually went out there and won an award, surprisingly. We won the Connect Award. It's for sharing with your community about FIRST.
So what's the future hold for our very first Horry County Schools team to take on the FIRST Technology Challenge?
We're already planning on doing it next year. We have meetings where we're going to recruit maybe another member. We're going to implement methods in our program, and we're going to start doing our engineering journal prior to the beginning of the announcement of the season.
Wow. And congratulations to the Ocean Bay Middle School's first Technology Challenge team. They are, as I said before, the very first in our district to participate in that specific robotics competition, and they want you to compete with them next year. If you want more information on the first Technology Challenge, please call Ocean Bay Middle at 903-8420, and they will put you in touch with that team's volunteers and coaches. It is amazing what these kids can invent and create, and you can't miss it. The Horry County Schools Technology Fair is free admission and free parking at the Myrtle Beach Convention Center. Now, for more information, please log on to horrycountyschools.net and check out our Facebook. We are now going live from events like these, and it's really, really cool. And of course, keep watching us right here the next time we take you inside Horry County Schools.